Recently, we took apart a Dell 465W power adapter for laptop, and today we got another product also from Dell, which is a server power supply. It has passed the 80 plus platinum standard and supports an output of 12 volts, 41.25 amp, which is 495 watts. We're curious about the internal components of this power supply, so let's take it apart and see how it differs from the laptop power adapter. There is an AC socket and a fan on the input end, and the fan is fixed with screws. The light guiding handle in the middle can be used as an indicator. The orange handle near the AC socket is used for quick release. You can take out the power supply by pressing it. Its case is made of metal and fixed with screws. All specs info are printed on this sticker. Model is D495E-S0. It supports input of 100 to 240 volts, 50 or 60 hertz, 6.5 amp to 3 amp. And it can also support output of 12 volts, 41.25 amp and 12 volts, 3 amp under standby. The manufacturer is Delta. It has passed CE and KC certifications. As mentioned at the beginning, it has passed the 80 plus platinum standard. The output end has ventilation for heat dissipation. The size is about 200 by 86 by 39 mm. Since it's large size, the weight is about 921 grams. Next, let's start to take it apart. Unscrew the fixing screws and remove the upper case. As you can see, the PCBA module is covered by black mylar sheets for insulation and is screwed to the bottom case. Remove the remaining screws. The indicator light PCB is also fixed with screws. Take away the wires of the fan and the indicator light. There are fuse and safety X2 capacitor on the front. The vertical PCB of power control is under the electrolytic capacitor, and the MOSFET is fixed by the heatsink above the electrolytic capacitor. The power measurement IC, two master control chips, MOSFET, and sampling resistor are on the back. The fan is from Delta, 12 volts, 0.81 amp. The PCB of the two-color indicator light is connected to the main PCB by wire. The AC socket has an iron piece that contacts the case for grounding. Let's see each component one by one. The input fuse is insulated by heat shrinkable tubing. The safety X2 capacitor under the fuse is from HJC, 1 microfarad. The yellow varistor is used for input voltage surge protection. The NTC thermistor is used to limit the surge current after powering on. The relay is from TE. It is used to short circuit the NTC thermistor and improve power conversion efficiency. Its coil voltage is 12 volts and the contact rating is 8 amp. Those two common mode chokes are wound with magnet and insulated wires, and they were also insulated with Bakelite. The safety X2 capacitor is insulated by tape, and there are two blue-white capacitors next to it. The bridge rectifier is from Shindengen, 15 amp, 600 volts. Next, let's take a look at the PFC circuit. The PFC MOSFET is from Infineon and adopts TO247 package, 650 volts, 190 milliohm. The PFC bus inductor and PFC rectifier are inside the heatsink. The model of the PFC rectifier is blocked by the boost inductor. The electrolytic capacitor for input filtering is from Rubycon, 450 volts, 470 microfarad. The master control chip is from Texas Instruments. It's a phase-shifted full bridge controller with synchronous rectification, and it has the capability of enhanced wide-range resonant zero-voltage switching and light load efficiency. Two transformers for isolating drive are insulated by tapes. Both drivers for the transformer are from Texas Instruments. These two MOSFETs soldered on the front of this heatsink are from SD Micro and adopt TO220FP package, 600 volts, 370 milliohm. Another two MOSFETs are on the back of the heatsink we mentioned. ChargerLab found that it adopts a phase-shifted full bridge design. Move to the synchronous rectification circuit. These four MOSFETs from Infineon are soldered on this synchronous rectifier PCB, and they adopt a PG-TDSON-8 package. 75 volts 4.2 mA. The filter inductor for output filtering is wound with magnet wires. The electrolytic capacitor for output filtering is from Rubycon, 16 volts 2200 microfarad. And this electrolytic capacitor is the same as the previous one. These two small electrolytic capacitors are from Rubycon ZLH series, 16 volts 470 microfarad. Three MOSFETs for output control are under those two electrolytic capacitors. They were all from Infineon and adopt a PQFN 5x6 package, 25 volts 1.15 mA. The power measurement IC at AC input end is from ADI. It integrates 4 signal inputs, 22-bit ADC and 32-bit computing unit, as well as 8-bit MPU and 32 kilobytes flash. The external crystal oscillator for the IC is 32.768 kHz. The mass control chip for auxiliary power supply is from Onsemi. The MOSFET for auxiliary power supply is from Infineon and adopts TO252 package, 800 volts, 900 mA. Let's move to the vertical PCB of power control we mentioned before. The MCU, digital isolator, and other components are soldered on it. One of the MCU is from Microchip and is used to drive PFC MOSFET. It integrates 16-bit CPU, high-speed PWM, ADC, and high-speed comparator. The other MCU is also from Microchip, and it integrates a high-performance core. It is used to execute digital filtering algorithms and high-speed precision digital control loops. This external crystal oscillator for the MCU is 60 MHz. The driver from Texas Instruments is used to drive PFC MOSFET. The dual voltage comparator is used for signal detection. The low power core channel digital isolator is from Skyworks, and it has a transfer speed of 150 megabits per second. Well, those are all components of this Dell 495 watts servo power supply. It is manufactured by Delta and has passed the 80 plus platinum standard. Since it is a servo power supply, its size is much larger than the laptop power adapter. The long-term and stable power supply performance requires better heat dissipation, so its components are more sparse than the power adapter. And most components are from well-known manufacturers such as Rubycon, Microchip, Texas Instruments, Onsemi, etc. All of which makes it meet the high performance requirements of the server. Okay, that's all for today's video. Please drop a like, leave your comments, and subscribe to us. See you in the next video. Bye!